Blessed is our God, always now and forever. Jesus, amen. Our God.
To you, O Lord.
For to you belong all glory, honor, and worship, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Thank you.
star of dazzling clarity, amen, a vision illumined by the brightness of the Trinity. You entered the dark cloud of the Spirit, and like Moses, you penetrated the mysteries of God, which you clearly explained to us with a melodious tongue. Intercede with God that He may save our souls. Sophia, Orphia, Oscillaron, Aias, Doxis, Athanatu, Patros, Uraniu, Aiu, Makaros,
yes,
Save me, O God, by your name. The reading is from the prophecy of Isaiah, wisdom, let us be attentive. Thus says the Lord, all nations are gathered together, and the princes shall be gathered out of them. Who will declare these things among them, or who will declare to you from these things from the beginning? Let them bring forth their witnesses and be justified. Let them hear and declare and their truth. Be my witnesses, and I too am a witness, says the Lord God, my servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me, and understand and know that I am. Before me there is no other God, and after me there shall be none. I am God, and besides me there is no Savior. I have declared and have been saved, and I have saved. I have reproached, and there was no strange God among me. You are my witnesses, and I am witness, says the Lord. Even from the beginning I am, and there was none that can deliver out of my hands. I will work, and who shall turn it back? Thus says the Lord God that redeemed you, the Holy One of Israel. Wisdom, let us be attentive.
The souls of the righteous are in the hands of God, and there shall no torment touch them. In the sight of the unwise, they seem to die, and their departure is taken from, and they are going for us to be utter destruction, but they are in peace. For though they may be punished in the sight of men, yet in their hope for them immortality. And having been in a little chastised, they shall be greatly rewarded, for God proved them and found them worthy for himself, as gold in
wisdom, let us be attentive.
For though the righteous happen to die, and yet shall be in rest for honorable ages, not that which standeth in length of time, nor that which is measured by number of years. But wisdom is the gray hair unto man, and an unspotted life is old age. He pleased God and was beloved of him, so that living among sinners he was translated, yea, speedily was he taken away, lest that wickedness should alter his understanding. His soul. For the fascination of wickedness doth obscure things that are honest, and the wondering and the desire doth undermine the simple one. He being made perfect in a short time, fulfilled a long time, for his soul pleased the Lord. Therefore hastened he to take him away from among the wicked. This the people saw and understood it not, neither did they lay this upon their minds, that his grace and mercy is with his saints, and that he doth visit.
Let us say with our whole soul, with all our mind, let us say,
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Almighty, the God of our fathers, we pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We pray to you, hear us, and have mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for all pious and orthodox Christians.
Lord,
and we pray for our Archbishop and Father Saba.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for the brethren, priests, higher monks, deacons, and monastics, and all our brothers and sisters in Christ.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for mercy, life, peace, health, salvation, visitation, forgiveness, and remission of the sins of the servants of God, all pious and orthodox Christians, those living and visiting this community, city, the members, council members, contributors, who love those members and benefactors of this holy church.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
Again, we pray for the blessed and ever memorable founders of this holy church, for our mothers, fathers, brothers, and sisters who are here asleep in the Lord and the Orthodox everywhere.
Pray
for those who do charitable works, and those who serve in this holy house, those who labor, teach, and sing. For all the people here present will await your great and abundant mercy.
Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful God who loves mankind, and to you we ascribe glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us complete our prayer to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
For a perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless day, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, and guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
For forgiveness and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask of the Lord. For all that is good and beneficial to our souls and for peace in the world, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
For the completion of our lives and of the remaining time of our lives in peace and repentance, let us ask of the Lord.
Grant us, O Lord.
For a Christian ending to our lives peaceful, without shame or suffering, for a good account of ourselves, and for the awesome judgment seat of Christ, let us ask.
Grant us, O Lord.
Remembering our most holy, you are blessed. Of the saints, let us commit ourselves and one another in our whole life to Christ our God.
To you, O Lord.
For you are a good and loving God, and to you we ascribe glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and now and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be unto all.
And with your spirit.
Let us bow our heads unto the Lord.
To you, O Lord.
The Lord our God, bow the heads and keep down from salvation of the human race. Look down upon your servants and upon your inheritance. For your servants have bowed their heads, and they have bent their necks to you, the fearsome judge who loves great God. They do not expect help from them, but that they await your mercy and look for your unexpected salvation. Protect them all at all times, during both the present evening and the coming night, from every enemy, for every opposing work of the devil, from vain thoughts and evil matters. May the might of your kingdom be blessed and glorified of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, both now and forever. Unto the ages of ages. At this time, we are blessed to have with us the relics of St. Barbara. They will be processed in front of us here, so that we have an opportunity to venerate them, and they will remain out for her feast day and liturgy tomorrow. In a wondrous way, O wise Father John, you have brightened the Church of Christ with your song, which speak of the things of God. You are another David, striking the harp of the Holy Spirit, attracting all to God with your sweet.
Lord, we are Father John, you and I.
con los dinatelemseos, καταξιοθήτωφος εις δέξαστε. Ω εις αφάτου σου, εσ πλατείας Κύριε ειρήνης, εκδομέντος άζηξε τον άνθρωπο.
Everything, well, I'm a southpaw, so you see me writing this word. That's not, he wrote
with his writing, you know? And he was writing joys of what the icons bring to us, why they are blessed, why, you know, in a church that reveres relics, what are the icons? And how we can venerate these icons in very much the same way that we venerate relics. Because the iconoclasts, you know, some of them, you know, still had a foot in this door where they would say, okay, relics are good, but icons are bad. Do we have relics of Jesus? No. We don't have relics of Jesus. So how can relics be good? Aren't they themselves, you know, representations of the people, a bit of the actual person? I mean, we don't think that this is actually St. Barbara. We don't. This is an icon. It's a representation. Some people call them windows. They're not really windows. They're more like reflections. You know, when we see the icon placed before us, we believe that it's a reflection of the saint. In other words, we believe that the saint is present. Not in the icon, but because of the icon. And so, St. John was fighting for this. He was trying to express to people, no, we're not worshiping this. This gets thrown into a fire and sometimes gets burned, not all the time. Because we know stories from the icons of that burn. But how can you possibly think of desecrating these images, especially the images of our Savior? We know that that's not Jesus. But we know that it helps us in our minds to focus our attention towards something that's out of ourselves. You know, and because if we worship that which is within us, we can be in danger sometimes. We have to be out. We have to worship something outside of our being. He does come within us. And St. John was trying to give to the nuances, but no one liked his writings. Or I should say the powers that be did not like his writings. Because when they found him, when they read the letters and finally found him, they cut his hand. So that he could not write any longer. And he wasn't against anyone. Just like Jesus wasn't against anyone. He was for the entire world. And this is what it means to kind of stand up for something. It means we're going to set ourselves apart. And Jesus knew this when he told us about the Beatitudes. He told us, without question, if you stand up for me, things against you falsely for my name's sake. When he says falsely, he's not talking about necessarily that the things that they're saying are untrue. What he's saying is, it's not just that they're lying about you. They can be saying that you're actually saying the things that you're saying. But what's false is that they're getting angry that you're speaking up. They're coming after you. And it's hard to do that. It's hard to say, everyone else is over here, I'm going to be here. And everyone else is the world. The Christians, you know, the true Christians really must set ourselves apart. Not from other people, but from the wisdom of the world. We gotta set ourselves apart. We can be in it, but not of it. We can love, but not have a false sense of what love truly is. We can offer our works of mercy. We can offer our hand without being affected by the negativity that exists whenever people say that we're just doing this for our own notoriety. We have to be separate from this. We can still be with the people. But we don't have to be what the people are or what they are saying. And that, you know, that's a hard thing to meet. And St. John did it by writing these letters with love. He didn't come chastising. He wasn't fighting wars. He wasn't. Many of the people at that time were fighting with each other, killing each other, hurting each other over the fact that these were blasphemous. He didn't come in this way. And even when they cut his hand off, he didn't chastise them for the fact that his hand was severed. He wished that they would learn the truth. He wished that they would know what the truth of Christ really is in these icons. That's what he wished for. And we know this because when he prayed in front of the icon of Panagia, when he went in front of the icon of the Mother of God with a severed hand, and in his great distress and prayer was falling asleep. That's how he exhausted himself in his prayer. When he woke up from his prayer, his hand was restored. One way or the other, he had a hand. There are two different versions of this story. The one version says that the original hand was placed back. The other version of the story said that it regenerated. That the other hand, you know, was still severed, and yet there was a hand. And so when you look at the icon, some of you have seen it online or in the net that I sent out a couple years ago. When you look at the icon of Panagia that was dedicated in his honor, in her honor, really, you will see the doxima, you will see the hand, the right hand of St. John Damascenos on the icon. Again, whichever version of the story you believe, doesn't really matter. His hand was restored by Panagia and by Christ. But that's either really his hand, which has been covered over, or it was a doxima, a mold of his hand that was created and placed on the icon. Either way, that icon is referred to as the Trigerusa, the three-handed icon. It's the only one that exists where there's that, you know, see a Panagia Holy Christ, and then another hand down here at the bottom of the icon, representing the right hand of St. John Damascenos. And this is the other part of the feast that we have today. We'll speak more about St. Barbara tomorrow, even though we have the relics out of Saint, we're hearing most of the hymns heard about her. It's important to also understand that there's another huge saint of the church. Not some neo-martyr that was martyred by the, not that there's any insignificant saint, but one that is revered by one on this day, December 4th. So we will continue our service now. I know that I stopped the veneration of the relics. Please wait until we finish the service and then we'll all have a chance to venerate the relics together. Please rise and we'll continue our service. Master, now that your servant departed peace, according to your word, my eyes have seen your salvation, which you have prepared for the presence of all people, a light to enlighten the Gentiles and the glory of your people Israel. Spirit, both now and forever, and to the age. of ages.
Please come forward to venerate the relics.